So let's go and look at an example. So let's suppose somebody puts these numbers into the 32 bits, says, hey, I got one in my sign bit, and then I got 10100010 in my biased exponent. And then in the Mantissa, I have a 1 here, 0 here, and 1 here. Then all the rest of them are 0. I intentionally put rest of them to be 0 because I didn't want to show you all the algebra corresponding to that. That would have taken quite a bit. So that's why I'm showing only 101 in the first 3 bits there. Now, what value does this represent? This value represents minus 1 raised to the power s, and s, since s is 1, because the first bit, the sign bit is 1, so it becomes a negative number. This 1 is already assumed. Now, what is the Mantissa? The Mantissa is 101 with all zeros. So let me just cross these off, because otherwise I have to put 20 more zeros there. So because there are all of the rest of the bits are 0, so that is 1.101 base 2. And then the bias exponent, I have these 8 bits, 10100010. So I'm going to put those bits right here, and since it is a bias exponent, I'm going to subtract 127 from it. The translation into the base 10 number for the exponent, bias exponent, is 162. I'm going to subtract 127 from it. I get 2 raised to the power 35. This particular number here, which is 1.101, turns out to be 1.625. And when I do all these multiplications and everything, this is the number which is being represented now by that by those bits in the 32-bit single precision representation. Now, somebody might say, hey, can you go ahead and do the translation in reverse, where you have the number which is given to you in the base 10, and can you convert it into the base 2 with this 32-bit representation? Now, again, what you got to understand is that I can directly see that, hey, I won't have minus 1 raised to the power 1, that this bit here is going to be 1 because it's a negative number. And then what I have to do is I have to figure out, hey, what would be the part of the Mantissa and what will be the part of the exponent, and also whether the exponent will be negative or positive. So depending on that, then I will convert that into a biased exponent to be able to take care of positive and negative exponents. I'm not going to show you how to do this. I'm going to leave this as homework. And this can be also a good program to develop, to see that whether you can be able to, somebody gives you a number between the smallest and the largest number which they can represent in 32 bits and asks you to find out what the Mantissa would be, what the sign of the exponent would be, and what the bias exponent would be. So that I'm going to leave it as homework. Now, going back to the bias exponent which we're talking about, is that 8 bits which we have represent numbers between 0 and 255. Now, what I can do is the bias is 127, so you subtract 127 from it so as to show that what is the real exponent which is being represented. It's from minus 127 to 128. But that's not the end of the story. The reason why that's not the end of the story is because actually the range of the bias exponent is not from 0 to 255, but it's only from 1 to 254. So somehow something is happening to the bias exponent value of 0 and the bias exponent value of 255. And then the actual range for the actual exponent will be 127 subtracted from here, and we'll get minus 126 and 127 as the range of the exponent. Now, why do we not have 0 and 255? Because what they do is they represent special numbers. And what are those special numbers for which those things are reserved are as follows. When we have a bias exponent of e prime equal to 0, that means that we have all zeros. When we have e prime equal to 255, we have all ones. And those all zeros and all ones stand for certain special numbers. Because we know that we cannot represent 0 exactly, because we have one radix point Mantissa in all of our numbers. So we always have 1 before the radix point, so we cannot represent 0 exactly. So the way to represent 0 exactly is to choose e prime to be all zeros, that is e prime equal to 0, sign bit being 0, and the Mantissa has all zeros in it and represents 0. Now, if you change the sign bit to 1, it represents negative 0. These are two distinct numbers which somehow are represented by using these special values of the exponent. Now, e prime equal to 255 represents this all zeros. So when you have all ones, when you have all ones, e prime is 255. And depending on what we have in the sign of the number and what we have in the mantissa, that would tell us that, hey, what numbers do they represent? Now, as an example, if the sign bit is 0, you have all ones in the exponent, all zeros in the mantissa, that corresponds to the number infinity. If we have 1 in the sign bit, you still have all ones in the exponent and all zeros in the mantissa, it represents the number minus infinity. Now, in order to be able to represent something called not a number, an example of not a number is something indeterminate, like 0 by 0 is considered to be not a number, because you cannot say it's infinity or minus infinity if it is 0. So the representation for that is that you have a 0 or a 1 in the sign, you can, either one is good, but you put all ones in the exponent, and this mantissa has to be non-zero. That means that one, at least one of the elements in the mantissa has to be non-zero, and that represents not a number. Now, in the same format, in order to see that what is the maximum and the smallest number by magnitude which we can represent with 32 bits is that, since we said 1 is always there before the radix point, and if you put all 1's in the mantissa, it's going to make the number bigger, then you have 2 raised power, the largest exponent is 127, because we don't use 128. Same thing, the smallest number is that we have to have 1 before the radix point, so we're going to choose all zeros in the mantissa, and then we have 2 raised power minus 126, because that would make the number as small as possible. So that's the smallest number which we'll have by magnitude in the 32-bit word, and this is the maximum number which we can represent by magnitude in the 32-bit representation. Machine epsilon, which is the smallest number which can be detected by adding 1 to it, is 2 raised power minus 23. And the reason why that is so is because if you look at the number 1.00000 something like that, these are the bits in the mantissa. The next bit which you will have in the mantissa will be 1 in the 23rd place, and with the exponent, of course, being 0. So this is equal to 1 if the exponent is 0. So this is 1.001. That's the next number which is represented. What does this represent? This represents 2 raised power minus 23. So 2 raised power minus 23 is the machine epsilon. Machine epsilon is also a measure of the relative error which you're going to get in representing numbers. So all numbers which are represented in single precision 32 bits will have a relative error of less than 2 to the power minus 23. So it gives you a good measure of how accurately your computer is representing your numbers. And that's the end of this segment.